Now, after Clausius' theorem, let's talk about Clausius' inequality. Now, second law often gives rise to inequalities. And as per Clausius' inequality, the mathematical relation is integral, this is less than or equal to 0. Okay. Now, how do we get to this? Right. Let's take up the case of a Carnot cycle. So now we know that a Carnot cycle is a reversible heat engine cycle. So a reversible, or you can say, if you write it down in simple mathematical comparison, the efficiency of a reversible Carnot cycle is always greater than the efficiency of an irreversible cycle, you know, provided both of them are working under the same temperature limits. So if you have a look at this, you have same temperature limits, you have one reversible cycle, one reversible engine, and the other one is the irreversible engine. And the same is true for a heat pump. So for a reverse Carnot heat pump, you would have the maximum possible COP against all irreversible heat pumps. Okay, so you have this reversible heat engine, and then you have an irreversible heat engine. Now they are working under the same temperature limits, TH, TL. Okay, we are giving them the same amount of heat supply. So this QH is same. Have a look over here. Okay, now but obviously they are different engines. So this gives a reversible work output, and this gives an irreversible work output. Okay, now due to this difference in the work output, you have different values of heat rejections. So the reversible engine is rejecting heat QL1, and the irreversible engine is rejecting heat QL2. Okay, let's have a look at that for the you can say reversible engine first of all. Now the reversible engine, if I take the case of, because it's a cyclic engine, if you take this part, okay, this is equal to integral delta QH upon TH minus delta QL, this is L1 upon TL. Okay, so this would become QH upon TH minus QL1 upon TL. Okay, so because it's a reversible cycle, for a reversible cycle, we always have this QH upon TH is equal to QL1 upon TL. So this would be the case for a reversible cycle. So this would be equal to 0. Okay, so from this inequality, I can say that integral delta Q upon T is equal to 0 only for a reversible cycle. So this is proven for a reversible cycle. Okay, so for a reversible cycle or a reversible heat engine. Okay, now let's come on to the second part, that is the irreversible heat engine. Okay, so if you look at this, because it is irreversible, the work output would be less as compared to the reversible work output. So this means, because this is less as compared to this, the heat rejection would be more as compared to this. So we know that QL2 is greater than QL1 for obvious reasons. If I have to equate it, I'll have to add something over here. So that's the difference between the two heat rejections. So you would have QL2 is equal to QL1 plus the difference in the heat rejections. And this particular value is always positive. This is never negative. Okay. So let's apply the same thing onto the irreversible heat engine. So you'll have integral delta Q upon T. For irreversible, it would be integral, not the cyclic part, but only the integral. That is delta QH upon TH minus delta QL2 upon TL. So now put in the values of QL2. We'll put that after the integration is done. So this gives rise to Q QH upon TH minus QL2 upon T2. If you put it in a bracket, you get QL1 upon TH TL. This is TL. And then plus Q difference upon TL. This is what you get. When you open the brackets, let's just get rid of these brackets. This would become a negative sign as well. Now we know from our analysis of the reversible heat engine that this part is zero. Okay, so this, these two things, it becomes zero because QH by TH minus QL1 by TL is equal to zero. Okay, so you are only left with this part. So you will get, let me write it down here only. So delta Q upon T. So let me put something, you know, very important over here. So this is for reversible heat engine and this is for irreversible heat engine. This is equal to minus Q difference upon TL and this is always a negative quantity. So you can see this inequality, you know, is valid for two kind of cycles. One is a reversible cycle for which this becomes zero. And the other one is for an irreversible cycle for which it becomes negative. Okay, so this is how we understand the Clausius inequality, that is, this is zero for a reversible cycle and it becomes negative for an irreversible cycle. Now, a very, very important thing to understand, and remember, we only have this much. This means that delta Q upon T, it can never be positive. This will never be positive for any device or any machine. Okay, so this is how you have to understand it and analyze. In a nutshell, I would say, if this is zero, it indicates a reversible cycle. If this is negative, it indicates an irreversible cycle. But in both the cases, in both these cases, the cycle is a possible one. You can have a cycle. Okay, but if you have a positive value, the cycle is impossible. It can never exist. Okay, so this finishes this video on Clausius inequality. Now let's move on to a further video, you know, and introduce entropy as a system property.